Yeah, this is the front of Freak Beat Records. Yeah. Very cool sign. And look, you can get your nails done next door, or your wife can get her nails done next door.
The noodle place is very
And there's
good.
A noodle place. Your wife, send your wife over to the nail bar, or send her over to the Zoom room, train, socialize, and shop.
That's for your dog, actually.
Oh, okay, send your dog over there, and then you come here and spend the day buying records. Okay. So we're at Freak Beat Records, one word, and what's the address here? We're in...
13616 Ventura Boulevard.
And this
Sherman Oaks.
Sure, they were in Sherman Oaks.
Yeah,
okay. Sherman Oaks. So let's take a walk through here and see what we got.
When I come through here, which is a few times a week, I start here.
Start where? This is new arrivals. That's a good place to start. Well, I'll go through there. I'm trying to control myself and just do a quick run through. So this is newer. So the records are still coming in all the time. They just keep coming. Is it the old people dying off, or what? Where is it coming from?
All these people up in the hills that work for the record labels.
Yeah, that's what LA has.
That nowhere else has.
Yeah. Now that must be an A&M pressing, because if that was an Island pressing, it would go for a lot more than $15.95, unless someone's pricing it low. Let's see. It is an Island. No, it's an American Island. Yeah, so it's Capitol. Okay. Still good. Still good. Okay, I like how they have the setup with the...
Yeah. Bob gets a lot of records into this space. He really, really does a good job.
I have never seen a copy of this album, of the American pressing of this album, that wasn't burnt. The whole run of them was burnt. You know what a burnt record looks like? We'll look at that in a minute and see if it's got it.
You mean... the grooves?
No, it's white. It's got a white. It's when the biscuit is too hot. Okay, here's another wall of cool things. The Buzzcocks cover compilation.
The cool stuff is super cool.
Now, are those records for sale?
The ones in the middle that you can't reach are not.
Oh, that.
Actually, this whole wall is not. This is just for show. But
that's cool, a full dimension. I don't know how much this is.
They got wiped out this weekend.
Oh, yeah.
All those empty places are the records that sold.
And those went to...
I don't know if they went to... I don't know.
Hi-Fi Music for Children. I'm not sure this GoPro is going to get that as well as I'd like. What a great Sun Liberty. Russ Garcia and his orchestra. Russ Garcia and his orchestra was like Esquivel.
Yeah?
Yeah. It was Stan Freeberg.
Oh, are you kidding? I wouldn't stay there in 9 years. But some of these guys want to get
autographed.
As cheap as they can.
The stand?
Garden of Freeberg.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. Stan Freeberg. 5 days. Yeah. You can't see that at home, unfortunately.
So
this doesn't have a zoom function. Hopefully the next GoPro will have a zoom function.
Here's some rare stuff.
And there's the Scorpions with the naked little girl. That's just so sick.
Notice how I got the sticker right over.
Bottles.
A lot of good records, obviously. Oh, yeah. Plenty of good records. I mean, anything outstanding that you saw someone...
Well, you know the private album holder?
Oh, look at that. It's only $50. Symphony Espanol. That's what those Deccas are going for, baby.
Yeah.
That's what they're going for. Yeah, I could spend days here, I can tell. Interesting things you can see.
The guy gets good stuff and puts it out. He's a bit of a prog fanatic. It's okay, I don't hold it against
him. Yeah, no, you can see $50 for the old Londons. Yeah, these are starting to get really pricey now. And the Mercurys are coming down a little bit, although it depends on which one it is, of course.
Now Bob uses the ultrasonic V8.
Because you can do eight at a time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're gonna do a quick.
Mm-hmm.
singles.
Boxes.
CDs, who cares?
Sometimes it's the only way to find stuff, man.
I know. If it's the only way to buy stuff, that's a different thing.
Although I bought Steve Gadd, Gadditude.
Uh-huh.
And I think it is available on vinyl.
A lot of things that you don't think are on vinyl are end up being on vinyl.
Yeah.
This is the new Brian Wilson. Is that any good?
I haven't heard it.
I haven't heard it either.
That's your GoPro, huh?
So they have all the new stuff out, which is good.
Who comes the guy that you told me you hadn't seen for years, the guy from the Netherlands?
Exchange it.
Oh, sure.
Leave it on the counter. Get whatever you
remember need. I told you I ran into him?
Guy
and what is this, the budget stuff
from
up
there?
Yeah, this is the dollar room. CDs, LPs, and all kinds of other junk for
and sometimes you can find stuff here.
Oh, yeah. There's stuff in here that didn't sell in 4 months, so we mark it down. So it might be worth more, but we don't have time. Yeah.
That's my favorite place
there
to look.
Go. Chris Hillman record.
Yeah.
Dollar.
Is this on, what's his name's record label?
It's the original copy.
Oh, it's on Asylum. Wow.
Yeah. Never sold.
Wow. I may buy that. I may buy that one.
Didn't sell.
I'm a schnurrer. I like to buy cheap.
Me too, man.
It's no fun buying expensive records because it's fun finding good stuff for cheap. That's
well, that's the best thing. But you know,
I am to the point now where if I see a record that I've been looking for, I don't care how much.
Oh, then you'd buy it, right?
I buy.
Oh yeah.
I buy. If I have something out.
This is a good record. Steve Marriott and Peter Frampton. So you don't see a lot of British records here. It's a good record. It's nice if you like the Kinks. Just don't find too much used Led Zeppelin anymore. Certain things you just don't find. It's a good record. Not been a good reissue of this ever. Well, this is Charlie, so maybe this is good. This is the new vinyl blowout section. Okay, I think we're good here. Okay, this is Permanent Records, and we're in Highland Park.
We're in Highland Park on York Street.
On York Street in Highland Park. It's a gentrified area. So Permanent Records is a play on words, like it's on your permanent record. Now we're going to take in with the camera, and hopefully
they have a store in Chicago, too.
Oh, they have a store in Chicago, too. Okay. Let's just take a quick look at what's going on here. Love Forever Change is $100 for a clean copy.
There you go. That's what's happening.
Dead Without a Net, $3 on vinyl.
What is it?
Grateful Dead Without a Net. I don't think I've ever seen it on vinyl.
$100. And here's the Kinks Arthur white label promo with the insert. $90 now. That's about where things are at right now. Not even a British pressing. Meet the Residents, I remember that. $600, look at that. $600. Oh, I've got this Plugs record.
I do too.
$70.
I do too. I've seen it for more.
Cool. $50. Judy Sill, I've got this. I got both of those Judy Sill records, promo copies at a garage sale. That was cool. Yeah, that's good stuff here. Not messing around. Look at that. The Cat Power record. That was like, it's $50 now.
Yeah.
The original.
How many did they make?
That's the thing. How many? It's like the records by
a couple thousand at the most.
Yeah, the records by what's the Wilco? Sunvolt. Sunvolt on Warner Brothers. Those are $300 now.
Yeah.
Cute.
Yeah. All the ones that I passed.
Okay, so we're gonna.
So, the people that are missing, they work hard to fill these bins.
Yeah, they've got good things. I can see that.
See them everywhere.
This is a better. This is a. Well, I don't want to make judgments about stores, but. That's right. That's the funny thing about stores. They have their own personality. $50 for the MoFi. See, the gem copy is American Island. You just don't see. Boy, if records keep selling the way they're going, my collections, things that I've got, crazy, that I just bought because they were when they were new, you know, because I bought them. $40 for the original of that. Wow. So far, I have not been thrown out of any record stores. Only the one in my town. Well, the next town over that I get thrown out of, but not when I travel. you just don't see too many used Led Zepp albums anymore. You just don't see it. They've got some. This one, that one's got all the faces in it, and it's only $20. And this one's got none of the faces. See, that's 15. Roxy Music. I don't want to see too much. Just that one. Yeah, it's pretty amazing. Like an original reprise, T-Rex, $30. You gotta hear the British fly pressing if you wanna really live.
This is cool.
Porky Pun Cut. It's got the sticker. Yeah. How much is it? That's not bad, $30. It was Tom Jones's?
Well.
It wasn't that Tom
I doubt
Jones.
If it's that Tom
No,
Jones.
I doubt it.
Who is you?
What is it?
Some sort of bootleg.
Yeah, it's boot. It's a booter. Most copies of Magic Bus are cutouts. I've never seen it. In fact, I don't think I've ever seen a copy that wasn't cut out. Only $30. You gotta look at the Matrix to know which one, whether it was the original or the reissue. It's a great record. This is a great record. And it's a British pressing. $50. This is a wire record. It's just a fantastic record.
I don't know. I have no idea if this is an original, but something tells me it's not.
Wait, I'll look at it and I can tell. Look, Wendy, here's your original The Shining, $80. What do you think of that? Do you have any copies at home?
I do.
I'm talking to Wendy. Oh. Not that she's ever going to see this, but... Okay, here's A Kind of Blue for $15. Let's see what generation it is. Look, it's a late pressing. Early jacket late pressing. You get all excited when you see that, even though it looks trashed. Beach is $40 record now to find an original. This is a good record. No, there's some good records here. The store's got some good things. Good record. Lothar and the Hand People. This is a great record. You know this record?
Not familiar with it.
Oh man, it's, he's one of the first guys to really do this kind of like stoner multiple. He's passed away. Beautiful recording too, the Vanguard Stereo Lab. So is it a black label or is it an orange label? I think all of them are orange labels, or that label. Look how far they cut that groove. They cut it right to the end.
Wow, yeah. Oh my gosh.
If you have a changer, you're not playing that record. You're not hearing the whole record.
That came out in the days of changers, didn't it?
Yeah. Yep. $50 for this in Marlowe.
Lance?
Be back in a sec.
Didn't have his wheelbarrow.
It's a nice record. I always like to look for classical records in a rock store. Because that's sometimes you can find really good deals. Of all record store days. I think record store days are getting a little crazy. Interesting records here for sure. Later pressings. This is a nice record. I got this record. Curtis Fuller, McCoy Tyner. Okay, I think we've had a good look here. And these are the cheap bins, I guess, are in here, huh? This is where you can have fun.
Yeah.
These Sean Phillips records are amazing sounding records. Whether you like the music or not, the sound on these records is
lovingly played to death.
Trident Studios, so that's why the sound is so fantastic. All right, I'm going to do a little bit of looking through here because I'm sure this is a good record. Dave Ray, Snakers here, Blues and Hollers, that's a good record. These records, these have the basement smell. The basement smell.
Moldy.
Yeah, man. Is that in good shape?
I was going to ask you. It looks good to me.
Well, we never looked at that other record, did we? That was some other record.
Well,
the mother's. I'm going to turn this off.